Have you ever been, yes you have, or you wouldn't be here, right? You've been in these meetings when Holy Spirit just rolls in. Are those your favorite? Don't you just, you don't even have to say anything? Just, that's the best. We just worship and everybody gets knocked flat on their face. That's like, that's my favorite. Nobody remembers who's speaking. Nobody buys the download, nothing. It's everybody's just out. But everybody's life's transformed. And I don't know, just seeing you, it helps me. It really does. I'm so happy to see you too. Yes. Okay, I'm going to read this, and then I'm going to share something about that. And a now time, and a then time, and a time that we're pressing in for. So I want to read from 2 Corinthians. Today, I was just so hungry. I got in from New York. God just crashed in the city. It just, oh, it was, yeah. Oh. It was just so amazing. If I somebody else will tell you where, but it'll rock your boat. And I got to go. One of my friends knows me really well, and when I'm away from home, sometimes I'm really missing some things, you know. And I've been on a lot of speedboats lately, like a lot of speedboats, because of all that we're doing in the relief area and sharing the gospel area. And because we can't go, we can't leave slowly because of some issues. We have to have speedboats so we can leave very quickly when we need to. So we have the big boats with the sails. It's just so, oh, that's the way to go. And they fit tons and tons and tons of food in them. And we just love that. But then there's the speedboat. And that speedboat has to go really, really fast to get you there faster because there's so many people that need Jesus and so many people hungry. But it also has to get you out if things are escalating. So God knows, he created all of us for what we do, don't you think? Like, I love what God gave me to do. I love it. I love the body of Christ. I love being here. I love being with friends, family, people. I just love it. So anyway, God knows that. So how are you going to kind of step in when you're in another nation? So like here. And how are you going to step in? And somebody, just a friend, just knows me. And so he texts me. He goes, we're going on an adventure.
Hey guys, we'll be right back to the message. I just wanted to let you know that Voice of the Apostles, one of our flagship conferences, is happening soon. We have amazing speakers, including Bill Johnson, Heidi Baker, Dr. Randy Clark, and many others. We'd love to see you there in person, but if you can't make it, you can also attend online. Click the link to learn more. Now back to the message.
And I was so excited, like, we're going on an adventure in America? Yeah! And I was like, yes! And so we couldn't get off the floor. Really, the Lord said it was dessert. And I was telling Rebecca, she was trying to be administrative, and she's so anointed, so prophetic, and I grabbed her, and I was telling Joseph and Sean, too, just earlier, but we were in this glory realm, and I just tapped her, and I said, it's dessert time, and dessert's not necessary. Do you understand? Do you know that? So in the spirit, there are times where God just, the meat is flowing, like the meat of the word, and the power is flowing, bam, wow. But then there's this, it's like this sweetness, the dessert. He just comes in, and it's after, you know, it's after the main meal, what we ate of his word, and we experienced in him, and I just felt it, and I got so undone. He just poof, dropped in, and that was it. Like, we couldn't really, we just couldn't. And the Lord started speaking to me, and I'm weeping, and I'm just like, oh, wow. Yeah, I'll say, we were in Wall Street. We were at Wall Street. Yeah. And the Holy Spirit just, and I'm there, and I'm thinking, whoa, we're having dessert now at Wall Street. There's no physical food, do you know what I mean? It's just all Holy Spirit. And it was so powerful. And then I'm thinking, wait, but I'm about to go on an adventure. And I'm gonna miss this boat. I don't wanna miss the boat. I don't wanna miss the adventure, but it's time. The presence of God is dropping in the room. And part of me is like, I don't wanna miss the adventure. I don't wanna miss the boat. But Lord, if you are giving out your sweetness, if you are pouring your very self out right in this room, Lord, it doesn't matter. My schedule's your schedule. And all. And as soon as I yielded to that, I just was undone. And then eventually, you could just feel the Holy Spirit just lift, and there were ways to get out. We set off an alarm getting out somehow to get into this car with dark windows, not because I don't like people, but I wanted to get to where I had to get to where I was going, and it was just, so we're in there. The captain of the boat says, you know, basically he's telling my friend, you missed the boat, dude. But he's like, we'll just get another one. So he did. And I'm thinking, when I'm around just going on this speedboat, now I went from this meeting there to this speedboat, and we're just speeding all over the harbor, and we stop in front of the Statue of Liberty, and then we speed, and it's like, got motorcycle seats, and I'm like, God knows me. Like, God knows me. I love speed. I love speed. I like to go fast. And I like to go really fast. And I'm in New York going, yes. And I just felt the joy of the Lord because God knows me. But I also felt the joy of the Lord that I got to have dessert, which wasn't necessary. I could have just said, no, I'm good. Thank you, God. I feel good. I'm good. Thank you, Lord. I feel good. This is great. No, if God is pouring out his sweetness, if God is stepping in with his manifest presence, I'm gonna miss any boat I need to miss. Because there will be another boat, because God will make a way. And there's something about, like, Randy and your life that you just keep on believing. We're going to keep on going. We're going to keep on. Do you love that? Because a lot of people kind of done that, been there, done that. We're good. What are we doing next? But if you'll understand who God is and that he wants to give you more of himself, but literally he knows exactly what you're doing next. And the joy of that next, and then I started seeing all kinds of things over America. And I started seeing how things were going through in our country, that many things were going through, you're going to go through in America. And as I'm on that speedboat going through, and I'm in front of the Statue of Liberty, and I'm in front of, you know, we're in the financial district, and we're here, and we're there, and God just keeps showing me things, and I'm like, whoa. Okay, I don't think they're ready for this. I don't know if they want to hear this. But I feel like people are sent a little bit ahead to tell you this is your greatest time to shine. This is not your time to be afraid. This is your time to shine. This is your time to shine. God's got this. God's got this, and God's got you. So I was preparing this afternoon. I was just in my room worshiping and just soaking, and I didn't have a lot of time, but it was just, oh, I'd love to worship in between worship meetings. And oh, Jesus. And I actually prepared a message. And then I got here. We were praying, and then I was like, nope, that's not it. I'm like, Lord, I prepared. So could we just, you know, even maybe once in a while have that one? But I heard him. And it's from 2 Corinthians. This is what I got now. I might have read this scripture before. Do you think that might be okay? If you read scriptures more than once, I told a lot of people my favorite translation right now is one that I don't understand. It's the Kimoni. I love the Kimoni translation because it's the first time the Kimoni have ever had the word of God in their heart language. And now they're coming to Jesus like never before. And they're hearing the Kimoni audio Bibles. And we're going in there. It doesn't matter if we don't know if we're coming back. Every time, you understand late. You totally get this. You understand, Jennifer. You're praying, right? Like, okay, there he goes. Oh, well, yay. I gave him to you. You know, Roland's at home right now in Mozambique praying for us. And I think that's really powerful. And we all have whatever we have, our part to play. So here it is, 8:55. Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Yes. That's an amen. Jesus Christ is the Son of God, and he is the one whom Timothy, Silas, and I have preached to you. That's Apostle Paul. And he has never been both a yes and a no. He has always been and always will be a resounding yes. For all God's promises find their yes of fulfillment in him. And his yes and our amen ascend to God and bring him glory. So, I always, you know, I'm really grateful that Randy laid hands on me 24 years ago. I am. But I'm also wondering about you receiving whatever you're called to receive sometimes. Because if you don't understand the seriousness of what God wants to do with your little life, and you don't understand the cost of what God wants to do with your little life, or you take it flippantly or tritely, what God wants to do with your little life, you might just want to touch that another and another and another. I love to be touched every day, but I'm ready. Yes, Lord. But there's something about your yes. Not your yes when it's easy. Not your yes when it's just presence is falling and you're just undone and you never want to go anywhere but that place. But a yes in the midst of the shaking, in the midst of the waves, in the midst of the sun, in the midst of the shooting, in the midst of the beating, in the midst of the jail, in the midst of people not understanding you, or in your world, people attacking you on the internet, whatever. There has to be something inside of you with yes, God has a yes inside of you that says, I will not be shaken. I will not be shaken. I will stand firm. I will stand with you, Jesus, forever because you are worthy. Whether I'm abounded or abased, whether I'm sleeping out in a bush under a coconut tree, or somebody put me in a 6-star in Dubai, whether I'm walking through the mud or flying in a helicopter, my yes is the same yes every day. It's not a wimpy, yes. I used to have that, yes. Anything bush, anything out there, anything unreached people group, that's my favorite yes. But coming here would be like, oh, no. Like, Yes. You know, the name of the conference is so embarrassing, and you check in and you're like, oh, you know, I'm just being honest, like, then you get here and you realize, wait a minute. We're all hungry. We're hungry because we're here. We're thirsty. And then when you get here and you realize, wait a minute, there's a hunger in this room, then the yes, the Lord just compels you for a greater yes. And you're not just a yes when you're in your most comfortable place, which for me and you are very different. Your yes is a yes to God wherever you are. Your yes, is there a yes inside of you?
Yes.
They're just like, I don't care what it takes. Well, I don't know. It feels too late. Maybe it's the first night. Just, maybe it's because, you ever felt that way, Randy, where one meeting is so awesome that the next one you're like, oh, please God, do it again. Do you ever feel that, or is it just me? Yeah. You're just like, some people think we're just like, yes, it's great. No, there has to be a yes, your yes, and our yes, and his yes. And you showed up, and you're in this hotel, and you got here, and there has to be this thing inside of you that's like, I will not be denied. I'm not leaving this place unless I'm transformed. Like, I showed up because I want God. I showed up here because I want God. I want more of God, and I want to be with you who want more of God. There's something about the yes, not just when it's an easy yes. Do you think anything in me ever thought, you know, as a missionary called to the poorest people on the planet, that I'd be where I was Sunday? Or Friday or Saturday, which there's just, what was, or today? What's God thinking? God hears our yes. God hears our yes cry. God hears our heart. We say, we don't care. Whatever you want to do, we're doing it. Whatever you want to say, we're going to say it with you. Wherever you want to go, we're going to go there with you. It's a yes. It's a yes. It's a yes. Now, it is God himself who has anointed us. Did he just anoint a few? God has no lesser sons. God has no lesser daughters. He anoints every yielded child. Everyone in this room has a place. Every single one, including the people that don't even know him yet, he has destined them to come in. We are going to shine, right? We're going to shine in this place. So he himself has anointed us, and he constantly is strengthening both you and us in union with Christ, and he knows us. He knows we are his, since he has stamped us with his seal of love over our hearts. And he has given us the Holy Spirit like an engagement ring is given to a bride, a down payment of the blessings to come. Yeah. See, that's what happens when Holy Spirit crashes in on you. It's like a holy seal. Like, do you want that? Yeah. It's a holy seal. It literally, you could feel it in your spirit. Like, Lord, I want to be sealed. And I want to say yes. And I want to say yes, not once, but every day. If you are betrothed, if you are married, I've been married 40 years in May. Thank you, Jesus. 40 years. That's a beautiful thing. Yes, you should rejoice, because that's a beautiful thing. It's not an easy thing. It's a beautiful thing. It is a continual yes every day. Yes. Blessings. Yes. 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 Well, the Lord has called us to a continual yes with him. And many break that covenant. Many run away and they do their own little thing, and then they do their other little thing, and then they come back and it's like, here I am again. And he just keeps drawing and drawing and drawing. He has anointed us. He has destined us. He has stamped us with the seal of love.